Hello, everybody. Our next speaker is Anton Marchukov.
Marchukov.
Okay. With yet another Repoman. Please give him a warm welcome.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to talk about Repoman. So, important thing to understand, the Repoman is like a Superman, but that works with packages. So, a few words about me. So, I'm a software engineer working on Red Hat, and I'm a member of oVirt community infra team. So, oVirt is an open source virtualization platform based on the KVM hypervisor. And we are infra team, so we are responsible for all the infrastructure that this project uses, for builds, releases. And we are also doing continuous integration, and recently we are also doing continuous delivery. And this tool was developed by us to make this possible. So what the challenge, why we did it? If you Google, you find some other repoman, not necessarily dealing with packages. But the thing is, we have the problem is that oVirt is quite large application. It consists of multiple parts. There are packages in RPMs, and we really have to deal with a lot of RPMs and also ISOs, by the way. So at sometimes we process around thousands of RPM a day, and we somehow need to make a usable composers out of this so users can install them, testers can test them, and all this stuff. And obviously, we are not having infinite resources, and we need to do it efficiently. So that's why this tool was created. And as you see, it has nothing evil inside. So the reason is that we made this tool for CI. So you supposed to run it as a standalone application on command line, or you use it from Jenkins, for example. And if you do it like that, that's why it's important that this tool doesn't use database. There is no database. Also, there is no cloud inside. It doesn't have any REST interfaces. It doesn't open network sockets that you're supposed to deal with or interface with. And also, there are no daemons inside, so it's not evil. And also, no daemons, so it's not some daemons and runs in the background and need to manage it. So it's completely have no state inside. So if you run it, it's always run from scratch, because if you have Jenkins, we already have a way to run jobs, define jobs. A Jenkins stores the configuration, and you can store the artifacts. So that's why this tool doesn't have anything inside. And yeah, you pretty much guessed it. It's a sweet old console application. So once you install, you just use it like this from command line. Or obviously, Jenkins is able to run command line applications, so you can run it from Jenkins. It's distributed currently as RPMs. It's Python application. But the problem is that it uses some command line application like create repo. It's from YAM and RPM sign. So they're not available as Python models. So we can't just satisfied from PI dependencies. So that's why it's in RPM. But if you have everything installed, then you can access it as a Python model, because it's actual Python model. OK, so what it does? So the idea behind the tool is that you have to define some sources. Then you can define some filters. And then it store in the output store. It's made pretty abstract in code. It uses classes, of course, so you can override it. So currently, as input sources, it supports the disk, the local disk file system, and that's primarily how we use it. It tells able to get packages from the internet just by using HTML pages with HTTP links. Anything that has links to artifacts like RPMs or ISOs on web page will do it. There is also a way to recursively crawl the pages and look for artifacts, but it's configuration settings. It also able to understand some particular HTTP applications like Jenkins. If you pass a link to Jenkins artifact page, it understands that it's Jenkins and will just download artifacts. So it will not be parsing full HTML of Jenkins. And we also support Fedora build systems such as Koji. That's primary Fedora build system. And also we support Copper links. So if you know what is Copper, it's like Fedora third-party repositories, then it will understand it. And for Koji, there is particular support. If you have like Koji tech, you can pass the Koji tech and it will download stuff from Koji techs. Then for the filters, so basically to the inputs, you apply the filters to filter the RPM. I think mostly we use this, only missing one. It allows you to, for example, take two input sources and use one as a primary and from second just feel what is missing because it understands the versions, it understands the names of RPMs, so it's able just to take what is missing. But you can also leave latest 10 last versions or you can filter by regex. And then it just stores it on a disk. So for storage, currently only supports the disk file system. And it's able to split it, I will show you a bit later, on RPMs and ISOs. Again, so it's pretty abstract. If you have other types of artifacts, you can define some classes inside and probably send us a patch because it really was meant to be a general artifact tool. And this is a real use case. This is how we use it for oVirt experimental repo. So oVirt experimental repo is an oVirt repository where you can install oVirt from it. But the thing is that it's basically updated on commits. So here at the left, you have some jobs from our Jenkins. It's, yeah, names are not important, but the thing is that there are a lot of them because oVirt consists of these sub-projects and each of them is maintained by their own teams. So they all build artifacts. But we as a CI team, we need to make one total repository of all of these. So essentially when something builds it from code commits, we need to take it and place into this large repository. And this is when we use the Repoman. And as you see here the structure, because Repoman understands the distributions and understands the versions and artifacts, so you see that it created subdirectory RPM, subdirectory ISO, depending on what content you give it, and then it's also created subdirectories for the distros it saw in packages. So it happens automatic by Repoman, that's why it's useful. And then from here, the latest, it's basically latest continuous delivery to oVirt that has just top latest based on commits. And as I said about efficiency, and this is one particular thing that Repoman does is that hard links are essentially included. It will create a hard link to the file if it's not changed. That's why we can really produce hundreds of oVirt repositories daily. Because if we will be copying all the files, we won't run out. We will run out of space pretty soon. But here, for example, we have the previous repository with oVirt. And you see that basically two new packages version were built. Like for artifact A, we have version 2, and same for B. And then when we use this only missing filter and ask Repoman to take this and just add this new stuff, it will basically hard link all the artifacts that are the same, so we'll, they won't really occupy any extra space. And since it's hard links, then basically if you delete this, this will stay because it's like separate file names, but no extra disk space is occupied. So that's very useful for us just because those repos take a lot of space and we only mutate part of them. But yeah, it also produces problem if you store it on different file system. So it can't really symlink right now. And that's pretty much it. So just to describe where you can find additional information. So this is my Twitter. Feel free to just ask questions. I will reply them on demand. And this is our infra team list. So if you have any questions regarding oVirt, how we do CI, whatever, then, or Repoman, just use this mail. And currently, the primary repository is our Gerrit. This is because we really do also continuous integration for Repoman. We test it on different Fedoras and OSs, and we build RPMs there, so we use our infrastructure. But there is GitHub Mirror. It's basically mirrors from Gerrit, so feel free to use it. We, as a Python project, support the read the docs, and it's pretty standard Python application. And if you want current RPM, there are now oVirt RPM repository. That's basically it. So if you have any questions, yeah, just copyright slide, because I took pictures from the internet. So I will be also available on oVirt booth. We have oVirt booth here, so as soon as I'm not on the second talk, then feel free to come.
Thank you very much, Anton. If you have questions, I come around with the mic.
Thanks. So if there is no daemon...
No, it's not daemon. It's so just
if there is no daemon, my question is how frequently you run Repoman to create repos? So
we run it, I think, several hundreds. It's Jenkins' job. So it triggered by commit to the code. We have like maybe 50 repositories where people make commit, and then each of them builds the artifacts. Yeah, that's all this Jenkins job. And so it happens several hundred times of day. And then for each of them, the Repoman runs. So it's hundreds of runs of it per day. And it's, it doesn't really need a lot to load. It just reads RPMs, parses the metadata, and then composes the final repository. And when possible, it creates the hard links.
And does it also read the RPM contents or only the final?
It reads only headers. So we use RPM library to read only beginning of RPM where the metadata is.
OK, thanks.
Yeah.
Hello. My question is, what's the reason of using Jenkins for producing RPMs? I mean, I know that Red Hat has a lot of different tools for doing that.
Yeah, but this is not really a Red Hat product. We have Ref that is product by Red Hat based on oVirt, but oVirt is community project, and community infrastructure uses Jenkins. Yeah, we are reviewing other tools, but Jenkins works pretty good for us, and it really hasn't anything we need right now. So we are a Jenkins shop.
Any more questions? Well then, thanks a lot. Give a warm welcome, applause to Anton.